So many people told me, and still do, what I can and can't do because of my disability. And I'm just like, watch me. I know it gets better. My name is Eva. I am a queer 36-year-old with cerebral palsy. Cerebral palsy is caused by a lack of oxygen to the brain before or during birth. The condition itself is not progressive, meaning it doesn't get worse over time. Because it's caused by a brain injury, it can look very different from person to person. Some people with cerebral palsy just limp, some need wheelchairs and nonverbal, some you can't even tell that they have cerebral palsy. For me, having cerebral palsy means that I use a wheelchair and that I am nonverbal. Using this letter board and the laser attached to my hat, I spell out what I want to say. Because I can't use my hands, I hire awesome assistants like Cameron who help me do everything from eating, typing, cooking, driving, etc. As a kid, my parents were amazing and figured out a way for me to do everything. So I skateboarded, I played hockey, I had water fights, anything any other kid would like to do. My parents were also adamant about me being in a mainstream school, so they fought for that. When I was 12 years old, I noticed I was checking out girls and not boys. I was very scared because I thought being queer would make me even more different than I already was. I came out to my very cool aide at the age of 12, and then slowly to my friends, and then at 18, I came out to my parents. But my parents already knew. I was pretty obvious. I was lucky because I got the mainstream sex education, but for kids in the special education class, it's so much worse. There's no talk about protection and safe sex. It's basically just like, don't date ever. When they show the diagram of the female anatomy, they even omit the clitoris. In my late 20s, I started to date other genders, so the identity of lesbian didn't really fit me anymore, and now I identify as queer, and it just fits me very nicely. Looking for information on disability and sexuality, I called many disability organizations asking for information. I was either curtly told no, or just hung up on. So I decided to create the information myself. At 19, I wrote a book called Queers on Wheels. It talks about things like how to hire queer-friendly aides, how to talk to your partner about your disability, how to adapt sex toys, and how to masturbate if you need assistance. With that information, I traveled the country giving workshops on sex and disability. If you have chronic pain, you can absolutely still have a good sex life. You just need to communicate with your partners. I have so many friends, both online and in person. They come from all backgrounds, but they are all awesome. There are way more resources and community for queer disabled youth today than there was when I was young. You have community. I know it doesn't feel like it sometimes, but there are lots of queer people with disabilities just like you. Look for online resources if your city doesn't have them, or if you have issues that prevent you from accessing them. I totally understand feeling alone, but you will find your people and have a good life. Surrounding myself with people who love me for all of who I am is how it got better for me.